Seventh month is son of Vilai Shama of the royal family. One of the chief officers of the king came with 10 men to Shedaliah, the son of Ahakim, at Mitzvah. As they ate bread together there at Mitzvah, Ishmael, the son of Nethaniah, and the 10 men with him rose up and struck down Shedaliah, the son of Ahakim, son of Shaphan, with the sword and killed him, whom the king of Babylon had appointed governor in the land. Ishmael also struck down all the Judeans who were with Shedaliah at Mizpah, and the Chaldean soldiers who happened to be there. On the day of the murder of Shedaliah, before anyone knew of it, 80 men arrived from Shechem and Shiloh and Samaria, with their beards shaved and their clothes torn and their bodies gashed, bringing grain offerings and incense to present at the temple of the Lord. And Ishmael, the son of Nethaniah, came out from Mizpah to meet them, weeping as he came. As he met them, he said to them, "Come in to Shedaliah, the son of Ahakim." When they came into the city, Ishmael, the son of Nethaniah, and the men with him slaughtered them and cast them into a cistern. But there were 10 men among them who said to Ishmael, "Do not put us to death, for we have stores of wheat, barley, oil, and honey hidden in the fields." So he refrained and did not put them to death with their companions. Now the cistern into which Ishmael had thrown all the bodies of the men whom he had struck down, along with Gedaliah, was a large cistern that King Asa had made for defense against Baasha, king of Israel. Ishmael, the son of Nethaniah, filled it with the slain. Then Ishmael took captive all the rest of the people who were in Mitzvah, the king's daughters, and all the people who were left at Mitzvah, whom Nebuzaradan, the captain of the guard, had committed to Shedaliah, the son of Ahakim. Ishmael, the son of Nethaniah, took them captive and set out to cross over to the Ammonites. But when Johanan, the son of Kariah, and all the leaders of the forces with them heard of all the evil that Ishmael, the son of Nethaniah, had done, they took all their men and went to fight against Ishmael, the son of Nethaniah, and came upon him at the great pool that is in Gibeon. And when all the people who were with Ishmael saw Johanan, the son of Kariah, and all the leaders of the forces with them, they rejoiced. So all the people whom Ishmael had carried away captive from Mitzpah turned around and came back and went to Johanan, the son of Kariah. But Ishmael, the son of Nethaniah, escaped from Johanan with 8 men and went to the Ammonites. Then Johanan, the son of Kariah, and all the leaders of the forces with them took from Mitzpah all the rest of the people whom he had recovered from Ishmael, the son of Nethaniah, after he had struck down Shedaliah, the son of Ahakim, soldiers, women, children, and eunuchs, whom Johanan brought from Gibeon. And they went and stayed at Geruth Shemam near Bethlehem, intending to go to Egypt because of the Chaldeans, for they were afraid of them, because Ishmael, the son of Nethaniah, had struck down Shedaliah, the son of Ahakim, whom the king of Babylon had made governor over the land. Keep in mind, friends, they were intending to go to Egypt. This is very important. Show us the way we should go. said to Jeremiah, "May the Lord be a true and faithful witness against us if we do not act according to all the word with which the Lord your God sends you to us. Whether it is good or bad, we will obey the voice of the Lord our God, to whom we are sending you, that it may be well with us when we obey the voice of the Lord our God." At the end of 10 days, the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah. Then he summoned Johanan, the son of Kareah, and all the commanders of the forces who were with him, and all the people from the least to the greatest, and said to them, "Thus says the Lord God of Israel, to whom you sent me to present your plea for mercy before him, if you will remain in this land, then I will build you up and not pull you down. I will plant you and not pluck you up. For I relent of the disaster that I did to you. Do not fear the king of Babylon, of whom you are afraid. Do not fear him, declares the Lord. For I am with you to save you and to deliver you from his hand. I will grant you mercy, that he may have mercy on you and let you remain in your own land. But if you say, 'We will not remain in this land,' disobeying the voice of the Lord your God and saying, 'No, we will go to the land of Egypt, where we shall not see war or hear the sound of the trumpet or be hungry for bread, and we will dwell there,' then hear the word of the Lord, O remnant of Judah. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, if you set your face to enter Egypt and go to live there, then the sword that you fear shall overtake you there in the land of Egypt. And the famine of which you are afraid shall follow close after you to Egypt, and there you shall die. All the men who set their faces to go to Egypt to live there shall die by the sword, by famine, and by pestilence. They shall have no remnant or survivor from the disaster that I will bring upon them. For thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, as my anger and my wrath were poured out on the inhabitants of Jerusalem, so my wrath will be poured out on you. Go to Egypt. You shall become an execration, a horror, a curse, and a taunt. You shall see this place no more. The Lord has said to you, O remnant of Judah, do not go to Egypt. Know for a certainty that I have warned you this day, that you have gone astray at the cost of your lives. For you sent me to the Lord your God, saying, 'Pray for us to the Lord our God, and whatever the Lord our God says, declare to us, and we will do it.' And I have this day declared to you, but you have not obeyed the voice of the Lord your God in anything that he sent me to tell you. Now therefore know for a certainty that you shall die by the sword, by famine, and by pestilence in the place where you desire to go live." So friends, if you're following along, there's only a few people the land of Judah, and they asked Jeremiah to pray to God on their behalf and ask him if they should go to Egypt or if they should stay in the land of Judah. And after 10 days, God answered them, and he told them that he would deliver them from the king of Babylon if they stayed in Judah. Them not to go to Egypt. This is a very important point, friends. Because the first point that I wanted to make, and that I feel like I'm inclined to share with you, is to just simply trust in the Lord. As we've seen many times throughout the Bible, people have gone to the Lord, and being the big God that he is, he gives us all free will. So he gives us the will to choose if we're gonna listen and trust in him and have faith in him. Because, you know, so many things happen in our lives, and, you know, God may put us in a place where we don't want to be, or where we're afraid, or where there's uncertainty, and we're like, "God, are you sure you want us to be here?" And so just one of the biggest things that we can learn from the Judeans and Jeremiah here is to do the opposite of what they did. Trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord whether he gives you an answer or not. Trust in the Lord though, especially if he gives you a clear answer. Just just hold fast in faith. And if you ever have an issue with doubt or with faithlessness in whatever God has answered you, pray to Him about that. You know, say, Lord, I'm scared, or I'm concerned, or I'm unsure because this doesn't seem like something that I should do. Pray to God. Our God is an understanding God. He knows what we feel before we even tell Him what we feel. And so, the biggest thing is trust in the Lord. Alright, let's continue with Jeremiah 43. When Jeremiah finished speaking to all the people all these words of the Lord their God, with which the Lord their God had sent him to them, Azariah the son of Hoshaiah, and Johanan the son of Kariah, and all the insolent men said to Jeremiah, "You are telling a lie. The Lord our God did not send you to say, 'Do not go to Egypt to live there.' But Baruch, the son of Neriah, has set you against us to deliver us into the hand of the Chaldeans, that they may kill us or take us into exile in Babylon." So Johanan, the son of Kariah, and all the commanders of the forces and all the people did not obey the voice of the Lord to remain in the land of Judah. But Johanan, the son of Kariah, and all the commanders of the forces took all the remnant of Judah who had returned to live in the land of Judah from all the nations to which they had been driven. The men, the women, the children, the princesses, and every person whom Nebuzaradan, the captain of the guard, had left with Shedaliah, the son of Ahakim, son of Shaphan, also Jeremiah the prophet, and Baruch, the son of Neriah, and they came into the land of Egypt, for they did not obey the voice of the Lord, and they arrived at Tahpenes. Then the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah in Tahpenes, "Take in your hands large stones and hide them in the mortar in the pavement, that is at the entrance to Pharaoh's palace in Tahpenes, in the sight of the men of Judah, and say to them, 'Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, behold, I will send and take Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, my servant, and I will set his throne above these stones that I have hidden, and he will spread his royal canopy over them. He shall come and strike the land of Egypt, giving over to the pestilence those who are doomed to pestilence, to captivity those who are doomed to captivity, and to the sword those who are doomed to the sword. I shall kindle a fire in the temples of the gods of Egypt, and he shall burn them and carry them away captive. And he shall clean the land of Egypt as a shepherd cleans his cloak of vermin, and he shall go away from there in peace. He shall break the obelisks of Heliopolis, which is in the land of Egypt, and the temples of the gods of Egypt he shall burn with fire." So friends, that brings us to our second point here, which is just to, one, trust in the Lord, and number two, stay the course with God. And I say stay the course with God because, number one, Says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel. You have seen all the disaster that I brought upon Jerusalem and all the cities of Judah. Behold, this day they are a desolation, and no one dwells in them, because of the evil that they committed, provoking me to anger, and that they went to make offerings and serve other gods that they knew not, neither they, nor you, nor their fathers. Yet I persistently sent to you all my servants, the prophets, saying, Oh, do not do this abomination that I hate. But they did not listen or incline their ear to turn from their evil and make no offerings to other gods. Therefore my wrath and my anger were poured out and kindled in the cities of Judah and in the streets of Jerusalem. And they became a waste and a desolation as at this day. And now thus says the Lord, the God of hosts, the God of Israel, why do you commit this great evil against yourself? To cut off from you man and woman, infant and child, from the midst of Judah, leaving you no remnant. Why don't you provoke me to anger with the works of your hands, making offerings to other gods in the land of Egypt where you have come to live, so that you may be cut off and become a curse and a taunt among all the nations of the earth? Have you forgotten the evil of your fathers, the evil of the kings of Judah, the evil of their wives, your own evil and the evil of your wives, which they committed in the land of Judah and in the streets of Jerusalem? They have not humbled themselves even to this day, nor have they feared, nor have they walked in my law and my statutes that I set before you and before your fathers. Therefore, thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, Behold, I will set my face against you for harm, to cut off all Judah. I will take the remnant of Judah, who have set their faces to come to the land of Egypt to live, and they shall all be consumed. In the land of Egypt they shall fall, by the sword and by famine they shall be consumed, from the least to the greatest. They shall die by the sword and by famine, and they shall become an oath, or a curse, and a taunt. I will punish those who dwell in the land of Egypt, as I have punished Jerusalem, with the sword, with famine, and with pestilence, so that none of the remnant of Judah have come to live in the land of Egypt shall escape or survive or return to the land of Judah, to which they desire to return to dwell there, for they shall not return except some fugitives. Then all the men who knew that their wives had made offerings to other gods, and all the women who stood by a great assembly, all the people who lived in Pathros in the land of Egypt, answered Jeremiah, As for the word that you have spoken to us in the name of the Lord, we will not listen to you. But we will do everything that we have vowed, make offerings to the Queen of Heaven and pour out drink offerings to her, as we did, both we and our fathers, our kings and our officials in the cities of Judah and in the streets of Jerusalem. For then we had plenty of food and prospered, and we saw no disaster. But since we left off making offerings to the Queen of Heaven and pouring out drink offerings to her, we have lacked everything because you sinned against the Lord and did not obey the voice of the Lord, or walk in his law and his statutes and in his testimonies, that this disaster has happened to you as at this day. Jeremiah said to all the people and all the women, hear the word of the Lord, all you of Judah who are in the land of Egypt. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, you and your wives have declared with your mouths and have fulfilled it with your hands, saying, we will surely perform our vows that we have made to make offerings to the Queen of Heaven and to pour out drink offerings to her. Then confirm your vows and perform your vows. Therefore, hear the word of the Lord, all you of Judah who dwell in the land of Egypt. Behold, I have sworn by my great name, says the Lord, that my name shall no longer be invoked by the mouth of any man of Judah in all the land of Egypt, saying, as the Lord God lives, behold, I am watching over them for disaster and not for good. All the men of Judah who are in the land of Egypt shall be consumed by the sword and by famine until there is an end to them. And those who escape the sword shall return from the land of Egypt to the land of Judah, few in number, and all the remnant of Judah who came into the land of Egypt to live shall know whose word will stand, mine or theirs. This shall be the sign to you, declares the Lord, that I will punish you in this place, in order that you may know that my words will surely stand against you for harm. Thus says the Lord, behold, I will give Pharaoh, Hophra, king of Egypt, into the hand of his enemies, and into the hands of those who seek his life, as I gave Zedekiah, king of Judah, into the hands of Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, who was his enemy and sought his life. And so, my third point, friends, is just to free yourself and protect yourself from any idols in your life, from anything in your life that may be causing distance from the Lord. And what I mean by that is, free yourselves from any idols, free yourselves from any things in your life that may be causing separation from the Lord. We may not have physical carved images. I mean, we do in this world, but you may not have carved images in your life. You may not do witchcraft. You may not do all of the obvious things, but consider how much time you're spending with the Lord. Passage to questions of you, Father God, that you will answer them and that they'll be able to hear you and see you clearly, Father God. Help them to have faith and to hold fast in any circumstance, in any direction that you give them in their lives, oh Lord. And if, Father God, all things are well in their life, I pray that you protect them from any spiritual attacks, protect them from anything in their life that may cause them distance and disconnection from you, Lord. We thank you, Father God, for being a graceful God and a merciful God. Lord, I pray that the rest of this week, or the rest of this day, or whenever my friend is watching this, Father God, that you give them peace in their lives.